This is Christ Living Spring Apostolic Ministry, CLAM, where the power of God wrought miracles through the hands of the anointed man of God, Pastor Wole Oladiyun, the senior pastor, as he ministers salvation, deliverance, and healing. Prayers, they say, is the master key, but you must pray with understanding through the word of God and the reality of your new creation to defeat the enemies of your soul. Your life will not remain the same as you listen to this life-changing message. Thank you and remain blessed.
Good morning, church. How are you this morning? As you have declared with your mouth, so shall it be for you in the name of Jesus. You will make heaven. In the name of Jesus. I say you will make heaven. In the name of Jesus. The basic why we give our life to Christ is to make heaven. Matthew 6:33. And that is what our Father and the Lord have been sending. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Every other thing shall be added unto you. But today, Christianity, we are pursuing the attachment instead of the principal thing. The Lord will deliver us in the name of Jesus. I say the Lord will deliver us in the name of Jesus. Proverbs 10:22. The blessing of the Lord, it maketh rich and hardeth no sorrow. I declare upon you this morning, any evil attachment your blessing has this year, the Lord will cut them off.
Amen.
I say the Lord will cut them off.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any attachment, any link that your blessing have with sorrow in 2016, the Lord will cut them off in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ephesians 1:3. He said, blessed be the God, our Father, of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. This year and beyond, let your life attract blessings.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let your life attract testimony.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Your life will attract progress.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every wrong person around your life that is making your blessing to fizzle away, that is making the oppression of the spirit of Pisgah to be strong and stronger in your life, the Lord will separate you.
Amen.
I say the Lord will cut them out.
Amen.
Every anti-testimony forces, every anti-testimony power, making the blessing attached to your name to just fizzle away, today in the name of Jesus, they will expire.
Amen.
Testimony with your name for the month of January 2016 shall manifest in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say it will manifest.
Amen.
Those using your problem to describe you, those that have been using your problem to describe you, very soon they will use your testimony to describe you.
Amen.
Maybe you don't understand what I'm saying. Those using your problem to describe you, I say very soon, they will describe you with their testimony.
Amen.
If you believe, just begin to worship the Lord. Just begin to appreciate him. If you believe, just begin to appreciate him this morning. Appreciate him. Just begin to appreciate him. Thank him. Appreciate him. Just begin to worship him. Just begin to appreciate him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Appreciate him. He's a good God. He's a faithful God. He has us in mind. That is why he's speaking to us, using everything to speak. Today he has spoken and he will still speak. Just begin to appreciate him. Just thank him. Just thank him. Just thank him. Appreciate him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Thank him. Just speak a song of your own and just begin to worship him.
Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, I bow before your throne. Glorious God, glorious, beautiful King, excellent God,
excellent God,
We say unchangeable, unchangeable God. Unchangeable, unchangeable God. Unchangeable God, unchangeable God.
Unchangeable, unchangeable God.
Unchangeable, unchangeable, unchangeable God.
Father, we thank you. We salute your majesty. Hallelujah. Because you are great, you are good, you are wonderful. You are the almighty, almighty. Ever present help in the time of need. The only God that has the final say. We salute your majesty. Thank you for this mountain. Thank you for the life of our father in the Lord. Thank you for the life of our mother in the Lord. Thank you for every minister in this great apostolic mountain. Thank you for all the workers. Thank you for all the testimony. Thank you for your word that is coming, ceasing out of the divine throne of grace. Lord, we say thank you. We return all glory back to you because it can only be you. Father, we say be thou exalted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, this morning, I present myself before you because the Bible says by flesh shall no man prevail. But with the Lord we will do valiantly. I cannot speak by my own power. You can decide to use anything. You use the rod of Moses. Even the house of Balaam, you use it. Lord, this morning, come and use me.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, behold your people. They have come to meet with you this morning. And the Bible says, unto you shall every place come, because you are the Lord that answered prayer. Lord, this morning, minister to your people.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Act of Apostles chapter 10 verse 13 say, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good, for God was with him. Lord, this morning, come and speak through me.
Amen.
Oh Lord, speak through me.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Minister to every need this morning.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Blessed be to your holy name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name, we're afraid.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name, settle him. 6:5:6.
Shall be showers of blessing. This is the promise of God. There shall be seasons refreshing, sent from the Savior of us.
Say showers of blessing. Say
showers of blessing.
There shall be showers of blessing, precious reviving again.
Oh,
over the hills and the valleys, sound of our mountains of rain.
To shower.
There shall be showers them upon us, oh Lord.
Grant us
refreshing. Come and now honor thy word.
Showers of blessing.
Showers of blessing.
Of life, atmosphere in our life to see another good day. Whenever you see another good day, it's a sign that God has not finished with you. To him be the glory forever and ever. I want to appreciate my Father in the Lord, our Father in the Lord, the destiny builder. Baba, you will live to enjoy the fruit of your labor. In the name of Jesus. There is a father and there is a father. Sir, you are a father indeed. May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Also, our mommy in the Lord, our mommy in the Lord. Mommy, you are wonderful. You are wonderful. Your position will not be faker.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You shall live long to enjoy the fruit of your labor.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
All my ogres, I salute you. You know I love you. We will get there.
Amen.
What you have taught me is what I'm doing. And the Lord bless you. So you are the minister, my people. Keep doing the work. The Lord will keep rewarding us. All the workers in the vineyard of God, our people in the sand room, the media, our people in the toilet, the traffic, the ushers, the choir. You are wonderful people. May the Lord bless you. And the great people of God in the house this morning. How are you this morning? You are wonderful. In the name of Jesus. I have a very short time. And I'll preach on the message, I reject evil load. I don't know the load you have been carrying over the year that is not yours. But today, from that evil load, the Lord will relieve you. You know there are some load you are meant to carry. But if it is by design, if it is by divine arrangement that you are meant to carry that load, help must appear. I will show you. Let's go to the Bible. Matthew chapter 27. Matthew 27. I want to read verse 32. Matthew 27 verse 32. And as they came out, they find the man of Cyrene, Simon by name, him they compared to bear his cross. At that time, Jesus, you know, Jesus was meant to carry cross, have he? But he has carried the cross and he was tired. But because he was designed to carry it, they compelled help to help him. Every load that you are carrying over this year, and help, there's no help inside today. Heaven will compel help to help you. I say, heaven will compel help to help you. But every load that is not yours, and you are carrying all over the place, today, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. Matthew 11, 28. I reject evil load. Come unto me, all ye that Abby, and heavy, I will give you. But it's so unfortunate Many Christians today, their case is like the case of the man in the book of John chapter 5. You don't need to tell that man that God can do miracle. He has seen it. He has seen the angel appearing and stirred the water. He has seen whosoever step into him becoming he. But whenever it was his own turn, another person will come in. God is telling them, he said, come. But so many people, they have come, but still, the load is still on there. You cannot continue in sin and ask the grace of God to continue. God forbid. God forbid. But so many people, the problem of today, Christianity is dualism. We want to be in the world. And we still want to be in the cry. It is not possible. We are neither cold nor hot. And what does the Bible say about it? He said, I will split you out. Ah, God will not reject you. God will not reject you. Any Christian who wants to enjoy sin, automatically we add evil load upon himself. Many problems a lot of people are going about with in the church. Even devil has removed his hand from so many people's life. It is as a result of their daily life. They are the one having evil load upon themselves. But today, because Christ is speaking, he said, come ye unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, I will give you rest. Say, I reject evil load.
I reject evil load.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of
say,
Jesus.
Every load of darkness,
every load of
upon my head, I reject you. In the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray. I reject you. I reject evil load. I reject evil load. In the name of Jesus. I reject evil load. In Jesus' name we pray. One day, said to me, the Lord bless you wherever you are. He downloaded one Dr. Lukoya message into my phone. One day I was listening to that message. Baba Lukoya said a man came to him in his office. He said the moment the man appeared, he saw the man, he carried a coffin on his head. And a woman just suddenly appeared from that coffin. He said, that man has one tribal man. He said, he has a man. Do you know anybody before who's fear in completion with a tribal man? He said, that used to be his girlfriend, former girlfriend. He said, where is he now? He said, the man is late. But when you see the man, everywhere he goes, he was carrying coffin. All over the place. Can you see somebody carry coffin and you wait? Even if you see a car carry coffin, the moment it's beeping behind you, what do? You give way. You can't see somebody carry coffin and say you want to. You don't do that. Because I pray for you. Every evil load that you are carrying over the place, over the year, today, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
You know, by divine arrangement, our head is a symbol of our glory. It's not meant to carry low. It's meant for manifestation. It's meant for crown. But so many people, they have removed that crown. I pray for you. Every low you are carrying over this year that is not yours today, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
First Kings chapter 12. I want to read verse 11. First Kings chapter 12, verse 11. And now therefore, my father did lead you with a heavy yoke. I will add to your yoke. My father has chastised you with whip, but I will chastise you with scorpion. You are going to pray. Any power that want to hurt, what? Lord, evil Lord. They want to hurt body, hurt problem to your life and death. Say any power.
Any power.
Assign or contract.
Assign or contract.
To hurt problem. To hurt failure. To heart disappointment. Into my destiny. Say I am not your candidate. What are you waiting for? In the name of Jesus. As I clap my hand. Expire.
In the name of Jesus.
Command them to expire.
Expire.
In the name of Jesus.
Expire. Expire.
Any power assigned to hurt to my life.
Expire.
Trouble.
Expire.
failure, delay, disappointment. I am not your candidate. What are you waiting for? Commanded to expire. Commanded to expire. They must expire. Yes, commanded to expire. In the name of Jesus, commanded to expire. Yes, they must expire. Commanded to expire. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Let's have us. We marry so that we can have peace now. We went to school so that our life can be better. But many people, they went to school, instead of their problem to be lesser, it became double. Many people, they marry, instead for their life to get better, the load was double. Why? There are power specializes in hardening problems into people's lives.
Say any power.
Any power.
Assigned or contracted.
Assigned or
contracted. To hard to my destiny.
To hard to my
problem.
Destiny. Problem.
Failure. Disappointment. Delay.
Delay.
What are you waiting for?
What are you
in
waiting
the name
for?
Of Jesus.
As
I clap my hand. Expire.
Expire. In the name of Jesus. Expire. 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 Expire.
Command them to expire.
I didn't get even low.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Moses carried evil load of anger. He said for him to enter into the promise, he died on the mountain of Pisgah. And when he got to the mountain of Pisgah, there was a discussion between him and God. God said, look at it. He said, you will see and you will not enter. And he died there. I pray for you. Every foundational evil load you have been carrying over the place, yes, that is making you to see goodness, but you never enjoy it. Today, let that power disappear.
Amen.
From today, that load, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ishmael, Esau, Reuben, they carry evil load of their father's house and they lost the promise of inheritance. What God has written concerning them, when you are firstborn in that family, authority belongs to you. Everything belongs to you. But because there is an evil pattern, additional load, they lost it. I pray for you this morning. Power assigned to make you lose your inheritance. You have lost your identity because of the evil law. And you are carrying it, you are no longer stating. And your back is now bent. Today, that law, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, many of us, we want to be better Christian. But we cannot just be. Why? Because that evil load is bringing a strange manifestations that we cannot even explain. You will now begin to wonder, okay, what is happening? Ki lo shele, a minute of a sinong, but something is pulling you back. It's a load. I pray for you. Every evil load that is pulling you back from giving your best to God today, let the fire of God consume them.
Amen.
Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. Wherefore, since we also are compassed about, we show great a cloud of witnesses. Let us lay aside every weight and the sin which do easily beset us. Let us run with patience the race that is set before us. There is a race that is set before us, but there is a weight that is pulling us back. And you don't even know what to do about it. I pray for you. Every strange law that is preventing you from giving your best to God today, fire of God will consume them.
Amen.
I say, fire of God will consume them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 4, 31 to 32. Ephesians chapter 4. I read from verse 31.
Let all bitterness.
You know, some people, they can carry bitterness for 20 years. It's an evil load. You are wounding yourself. Many times, even people you think they don't like you, they do. You are not even conscious of what you are saying. They are busy doing their work because they are concerned their work. They want to make progress. And you are still saying, look at me that way. Look at me that way. And you are still anchoring that thing. And gradually, the thing is causing problems for your life. I pray for you. Bitterness is an evil load. Every seed of bitterness that is preventing your best from coming out today, the Lord will deliver you.
Amen.
Put that scripture back. It's an evil load. Put that scripture back. And wrath, and anger, and clamor, and evil speaking, put away from you with all malice. If it is possible for us to see some people's heart, even as we are seated, you will see malice of 25 years. It's very easy for some people to keep malice in mentality. It will begin to tell you that it is God that will judge you. He has forgotten that with malice you can't see God. Because nothing unclean. That's what the Bible says. Nothing unclean shall be found there. Bitterness is an unclean thing. Malice is an unclean thing. It's an additional note because medically it will even cause sickness for your life. True of us? You don't have power the way people think about you. People impression about you, you can't control it. So automatically people must hate you, they must like you. So whatever that I cannot control, why will I begin to disturb myself? Why won't I face my life and move forward? My father in the Lord used to tell me, he said, if you like, let them say whatever they want. He said, I'm looking for another problem to solve. I want to move ahead. If you like, keep looking at me with the eyes of yesteryear. It is your... But before God knows that I want to move forward, why will I keep bitterness? Why? Why? Because I want to move forward. This year, you will move forward.
Amen.
Put that scripture back. You see, the problem, I keep saying, there's what we call the authority and the principle of God. What we want to enjoy now, what we every today Christian want to enjoy is the act of God, which is the authority of God, the act of miracle. But we are forgetting the principle. The moment you break the principle, forget it. Forget it. Most of the problem issues we are getting about can automatically solve if you just decide to keep by the principle of God. From today, every evil law preventing you from keeping God's principles, today, that law will disappear.
Amen.
I said that law will disappear.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It must disappear. Because this year, we must become the best of God. We must become God wants us to become. We are not a product of accident. God has a plan. For how long will you continue to make the hand of God to be tight? So many times God wants to perform miracle, but you are the one. Why? Because when they look at your heart, bitterness is there, wrath is there, malice is there. Even you have left your own matter. You are now a busybody in other people's matter. What concerns you is the appearance of somebody in the church. You have come to church so that you can make heaven. You have come to church to pray to God so that God will answer your prayer and become a better person. But your duty now, you have left those one behind, is somebody's appearance. He didn't greet me. I greeted him, he didn't answer. I wonder. I pray for you. Every evil law you have added to yourself. As a result of no compliance with the scripture today, let the mercy of God deliver you.
Amen.
Church is a place of righteousness. Why will you leave all those things out? It's an evil law. The Bible says, if only in this world we have hope, we are more miserable than on earth. That's the mystery of people's problem. Because our hope is so concentrated on this earth,
the reality, we have left it behind. And we have handed the load that God has not given us. Every load that God has not given you, but you are carrying all over the place. Let the mercy of God deliver you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If it is a load that you are meant to carry, and you are carrying it faithfully, help must appear. Jesus was meant to carry cross. When he carried it and he was tired, they won't compare. The Bible said they compare somebody. In that situation where you require help, heaven will compare help for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say the Lord will compare help for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible said God is not. God, how does that scripture put it? God is not. Olorun o kin soju saju. God is not a respecter of person. Anybody that accepts him, is that not what the Bible says? It's acceptable unto him. Why is it that miracle you have seen in the last of that is not manifesting in your life? Check your life. God is not partial. Check your life. You have no reason to envy anybody. God never created you empty. Discover your own, develop it, and market it. And you see things will happen for you. But instead of you discovering your home, instead of you developing your home, you have decided to create it, to add unto yourself additional load of jealousy, additional load of envy. And when you see others progressing, you are sad. And one of sin, I have seen in the life of my father in the law, the only way you can have problem with him is you don't want to do things excellently. You don't want to do well. While I'm there. But as long as you want to do well, go on son, he will follow you with all his spirit and all his heart. But how come when you see other people making it, you are sad. You are not happy. You have had that to yourself, evil load of jealousy, evil load of anger, evil load of bitterness. Evil speaking, bad mouth, bad belly. Is that what Christ taught you? You cannot see that from the Bible. It's not scriptural. I was into surprise yesterday when our father in the Lord gathered all the ministers in Ojodu PFA. He was telling them the secrets of the ministry. Telling them the secret of the ministry. That why he's making it. Some of us, we hide it. Because you want to reign alone. You don't know that if you hate alone, you die alone. You are not a success until you reach people. How many people can you point to that these are my people? But you want to reign alone, you will die alone. You need to reach people. I don't know why I'm saying this, because they are not here. But I know this is what God wants to do here this morning. Stop putting evil load upon yourself. Your home, have you been able to carry it? What concerns me? And I've discovered one of the things that helped our father in the Lord, he faces his business. But many people, their own business does not matter to them. You knew that thing is scriptural. When Jesus was on the earth, after he performed a miracle of he feed 5,000 people, the following day they called him, they wanted to make him a king. He said no, because he knew his kingship is not on the earth, it's over there. He rejected it. He knew the purpose for which he came. What is your own purpose? Why have you come to church? Why? Because this year we must become a better person. Ancient battle must disappear. Wherever we have held ourselves down, this year we must lose ourselves. Because some of us, what we desire is not God that we lose, or we are the one to lose ourselves. Because when it comes to jealousy, when it comes to anger, when it comes to envy, God cannot do that one with you. You are the one. You know where you are tied down. You will go to the same spot and you will unleash yourself. And you will say you will move forward. This year, you will move forward.
Amen.
I said this year, you will move forward.
Amen.
The scripture that was referring to that time was Act of Apostle 10:34. That God is not a respecter of person. God is not. God is not. Let all lay aside all these evil laws. Lay them aside. Let them go. Lay them aside. Because this year, this year is a peculiar year. All the goodness you have not been able to manifest all the years, as God lives it. Because this year has been declared the year of absolute possibility. When you look, when you go to your dictionary to look at absolute, that means no law can work against it. Nothing can work against it. Nothing. Every good thing you have not been able to manifest over the year. Because the Bible says, believe the word of God, it shall be well with you. And believe his prophet, you will prosper. And because God, through our Father in the Lord, has declared this year, 2016, as a year of absolute possibility, this year, good things shall be easy for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
amen.
I say good things shall be easy for you.
Amen.
The Lord will make it possible for you.
Amen.
Without struggle.
Amen.
Without pain.
Amen.
Ephesians 3:20 say unto him that is able to do more exceedingly abundantly above what we think or ask for, according to that power that worketh in us, beyond your capability, beyond your ability, beyond your strength, this year, good thing. The Lord will make it possible for you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Many people, they are going about the sickness that are not their home. Even in their family, there cannot be traces. Most of some of them can come as a result of this. When you see somebody coming, you do like this. Why? Because you have an issue. You face another direction. That thing is dangerous. So even when you laugh, you know, they say even laughter is a message. True of us, you can hear your. But some people, everything. And by the time you ask, you say, they don't like me in that place. They don't want to see my face. Who doesn't want to see your face? Who doesn't want to see your face? You don't have power to change anybody, but you have power to change yourself. Why don't you change yourself? By the time others see the changes in your life, you don't need to tell them. They will change. The prodigal son said, the Bible said, only emi o dide, emi o si to baba mi lo, emi o si wifun pe baba. When the father saw him, he looked at him, he said, come. The other one would think he had been harboring something. He was, when he saw his brother being reconciled by the father, instead of him to celebrate, I said, thank God, my brother has come. I pray for you. Everything that is not of God, wasting your time and your destiny, frustrating the glorious thing God wants to do for you today, this year, the Lord will cut them out.
Amen.
We want to pray some prayer. My time is gone. We want to pray some prayer. But if you are here this morning, you have not given your life to Christ, there is a load of sin on your head. And that load of sin, we make the wishes, the wizard, the occultic people, the evil environmental power, the foundational power to hide their own. So you will now discover what you are carrying. You cannot, your back is bent like this because there are too many loads. And two, God is angry with you because the Bible says God is angry with sinner every day. And the Bible says the prayer of a sinner is what? Abomination unto God. Here, we are not ashamed to call the sinner out. We are not. You are a Christian. You have your own wife at home. You are still pursuing another person's wife. When you're supposed to go home, what do you have to do? When your husband, when your wife asks you questions, why you see go do, you not change your face. God is not happy with you. God is not happy. Remember the hold you took while you take that, you know, and that is hold that is working against so many men, and their life is just that. You only need to change. This moment, I have just 30 seconds. You know you are here. I know another call has been made, but you know you are here. You still need, you need to make an amendment based on things are not right with you, that you are a sinner. You refuse to come out the other time. Now! It's another opportunity. Because God loves you. God doesn't want you to die just like that. God loves you. God loves you. You know this is an of God is giving you another platform that you must repent, because God has a plan for your life. God has a plan. God has a plan. You are not a product of accident. God has a plan. God has a plan. No. God has a plan. What God has written. Brother, look at me. Because you have come. What God has written concerning you this year, it shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus. Say after me, brother. Say, oh Lord, my God. Just stand up. Say, oh Lord, my God. Have mercy upon me. Say, I renounce the devil and all his works. I accept you, Jesus, as my Lord and my Savior. Write my name in the book of life. I pray for you because the Bible says, with heart we believe, and with a mouth, confession is made unto salvation, because you have done that. Power to sin no more. Let the power overshadow your life. So shall it be. See, just follow my lead. The counselors are waiting for you. You are here this morning. You notice any of the following. Because of time, I won't call you out. We just pray one prayer and I will prophesy the rest. You've been dreaming. You have been troubled with various sickness. You have been dreaming. You in your dream, somebody commanded you to carry a load. And you put it on your head. Money that is meant to achieve something, always go for problem. You need to pray. You discover your body is just heavy. You know this is not your, you want to carry your, something is moving around your body. You cannot just explain. Problem is meeting with problem in your life. You have time to solve other people's problem, or when they come to your own problem, you don't have time for it. Yes, you need to pray very well. You have character that are anti-progress. Yes. You can easily keep malice. You can hold malice or bitterness against someone to eternity. You are always give to gossip, and you discuss other people's matter. Today, the Lord will deliver you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Isaiah 10:27. Only it shall come to pass on that day that his body shall be taken away off thy shoulder and the yoke off thy neck. And the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Say in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Every yoke of problem.
Every yoke of problem.
Load of witchcraft.
Yoke of witchcraft.
In my body.
In my body.
On my head.
On my head.
What are you waiting for?
What are you waiting
for? As I clap my hand.
As I clap my hand.
Expire.
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 Command it to expire.
Expire. Expire. Expire.
Command it to expire.
Expire. Expire. Expire. Expire.
Yes.
Expire.
Command it to expire.
Expire. Expire. Expire. Expire. Expire.
Command it to expire.
Expire. Expire. Expire. Expire. Expire. Expire.
Command it to expire.
Expire. Expire. Expire.
Let them expire.
Expire.
Command it to expire.
Expire.
Command it to expire. Pray.
Expire. 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 Expire.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I pray for you. Every load of darkness operating in your life, let the fire of God consume them.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
From that trouble, from that evil law, from that labor, today in the name of Jesus, enter into your rest.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. In Jesus' name. Before we share the grace together, let the following people see the end of pastorate after the service. Captain and I, Miss Adeboye and Miss Damilola. Captain and I, Miss Adeboye, Miss Damilola, please see the head of pastorate immediately after the grace. Let's share the grace together. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ,
the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
This year 2016, my year of absolute possibility, I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. In the name of Jesus. Three powerful hallelujah to the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You have just listened to this message from the senior pastor of Christ Living Spring Apostolic Ministry, CLAM, Pastor Wole Oladiyun. To order a copy of our video and audio messages, please call 01-794-9712. 0807-658-1733 or visit CLAM Bookshop at Plot 126 CLAM Avenue, Omole, Ikeja. You can also visit our website at www.clamgo.org or join Pastor Wole Oladiyun for the live streaming of our services on www.clamgo.tv. For counseling and prayers, please call 0802-121-4355. 0803-826-6330 and 0805-564-2735. Join us for our Wednesday Revival Hour from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. every Wednesday and Sunday Glorious Service from 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. As you come, you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Settled.